And then there's Cordoba. What do you know about Cordoba? Cordoba is Muslim Spain, southern Spain. Cordoba, just to give you a snapshot of what it looked like in the 10th century. And if you want to cry, cry, but not for pessimism. 28 boroughs, 10th century, 1,000 years ago. 3,000 mosques, 18,000 properties, meaning a house with the front and the back and the fencing and the properties. 500,000 cities. Some perspective, that's the third most populated place on earth. Number one was Baghdad, 3 million. Number two was Cordoba, 500,000. And number three was Seville, another city in Muslim Spain, 400,000. Cordoba was known as the jewel of the world. People would go there for vacation just to see the uni in Cordoba, to see the Grand Mosque in Cordoba, the great bridge of Cordoba. Markets galore. Can you imagine markets for flowers? Other entire markets for rare flowers, markets for fruits and vegetables, markets for rare animals, markets for all different kinds of paper. All of this, and then the streets. The streets of Cordoba, can you imagine, this Islamic civilization in the 10th century was paved in stone. In Cordoba, the streets had street lights in the 10th century. There's a famous letter, even speaking of the University of Cordoba and the Umayyad University as well, from the English king of the time to Hisham ibn Abdul Rahman, who was the governor of Cordoba at the time, asking him permission, the king, that his daughter and the members from the royal court can go study in the University of Cordoba. You know what that means? That means, number one, that this was an intellectual hub in the planet. And number two, that we were the ones that taught the world tolerance. He knew that the king's daughter could be safe there. And the letter was signed, as the historians mention, your loyal subject, the King of England. And that's why Gustave Le Bon, who you may study in psychology, in college perhaps, in university, the French social psychologist, he said, if only the Muslims would have conquered Paris as well. This is a non-Muslim saying this. He said, because if they would have, it would have been like Cordoba. He says, for 600 years, we depended on the Muslims to translate for us Greek philosophy. He says, and you walk through the streets of Cordoba, you find that the people can read and they can write, and some of them even know poetry, in an age when the kings and princes of Europe could not spell their names in their own languages. Say Allahu Akbar.